episode 34, live from Sugar Hill. Here we are. I'm Dan Workman.
Gina Miller.
And we are really pumped today. We have not only special guests for our audience of one, but also an amazing band, The Autumn Defense. Mm-hmm. How did we get them anyway? How are they here?
Through a friend of a friend. A friend of a friend of a friend.
The hookup, in other words. Our audience of one today is Laura Bricky, who's no stranger to Sugar Hill. She is with Vitamin Water, and she did a really cool promotion here. Battle of Bands, actually, to send a band from Houston to South by Southwest. We got a chance to record all the finalists here, and Laura spent a lot of hang time in our kitchen, which was nice, and she's here. Laura, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
You're in there with the Autumn Defense. You already have gotten a pretty good idea as how amazing they are, so your ride should be pretty good.
Go ahead and take it away, Laura.
Live from Sugar Hill, it's the Autumn Defense.
Before you lie to me, just look around and you will see. That's no way to spend your life. And even though you sacrifice, just have some sincerity. At the risk of uncertainty, that's no way to be alive. Sacrifice.
All right.
How wonderful you are. You were the light that I saw from the car. How wonderful you are. How wonderful you are. That's no way to spend your life, and you know it's no surprise. You figure out eventually what you've lost with your clarity. That's no way to spend your life. Sacrifice. That's no way to spend your life. That's no way. Inside of me, and we are living the open supposed to hear the sleigh bells ring? Do I think of love in better things? Do I wake up and vacate my own place? Say the things that I always say.
This is a tender one, so you guys keep it down in there, all right?
this one is also from the record Circles, and this song is called The Answer.
Across the afternoon, quiet takes this town into evening's room, grounded. Airplane in the sky. Too far away to hear. The watch is going by. Find me. All day long. Close to gone. Indifferent to the sky, never too surprised to find me. All day long, close to gone, and holding on.
Well, we did have a record that came out last year called Once Around. And it's, and we did a pretty big tour. But this is our first time in Houston ever, our first gig. So we're psyched, and what hallowed ground to be in. And Sugar Hill, so amazing. And we're happy for that. I definitely love a lot of records that have been made here. And yeah, this is great.
This is called Every Day. 2, 3, 4.
California, you were to
all those lies. I always wanted anyone to take my side when I is coming as the sun in California. You are in my mind, brighter than the northern sky.
Much. It's been a pleasure. Thanks for having us.
Good time. You guys have a sort of a element of effortless riskiness to your melodies, and you know, you sound so good together. Like, I wanted to ask you, like, at what point in your friendship or when you met, did you realize that you sounded this good together? Because I mean, the whole is so much greater than the sum of the parts.
Well, I heard Pat sing quite a bit, and everyone sounds good with singing with Pat.
Wow.
So I kind of, you know, not everyone sounds good singing with me, but I heard you sing with Jennifer Jackson and different people up in New York, and Pat just has a great voice. He can really blend it. But I think we do have something over the years that sort of it's gotten a little bit towards almost a family-ish sort of harmony, you know.
Yeah, it was pretty instant, I think. Well, I remember going over to John's place in New Orleans. Sort of, we were both living in New Orleans, and we'd kind of been hanging out a bit around town, and we'd run into each other at guitar shops and record stores and chat about records and things. And
you recognized your own, sort of.
we were kind of, you know, both like, you know, looking at the same copies of, you know, Zombies records and Scott Walker records and stuff. And so we ended up hanging out together, and I remember going over to John's pad one night and we were listening to Forever Changes, and we just brought out the guitars and we started, you know, playing some of those songs, and we sort of realized, oh, we've got like a harmony,
right,
blend thing happening here. So it really was kind of part of the, you know, in the early stages of our friendship, we sort of found the vocal blend too.
Well, we were listening in the control room, and you know, Chris really had it sounded beautiful, and then all of a sudden I wondered what it would sounded like to you, Laura, because I mean, it was hyper realistic in here. I mean, just so intimate as to be unbelievable, and it withstood the detail. But like, what was it like to sit in the chair and just have it in front of you?
Well, even when they were just rehearsing, they just started at the same time, stopped at the same time, and you guys weren't even really looking at each other. You weren't counting it out. You just started and stopped, and I'm like, are they reading each other's mind? I truly thought that. That's why I asked how long you guys had been together, because you guys really
there's definitely some ESP stuff that starts to develop, I think, after you make music with somebody for a long time.
Even different projects too, you know. I mean, we've played on different records, and obviously, you know, Wilco and everything. So it's been, yeah, it's really, I think that the symbiotic thing, it starts to really kind of get deeper than just the, maybe just the singing, you know. It's weird. It's do enough of these, you know.
I was listening to Circles earlier, and just the orchestration of the music was amazing, but I felt like it was jazzy lounge 60s, like it would be really great music for Mad Men. I don't know. Or something like that. Like,
could
I
you
just
say that again?
Yeah.
It would be really great music for Mad Men, but here, return the favor. If you get on the show,
it's funny, we said that at Sugar Hill.
Yeah.
He's a fan. He's a Wilco fan. He's been out to quite a few shows. Maybe we'll get a chance.
Maybe so.
Well, I think that those other experiences, you know, Wilco and whatever, have informed something that's really unique and special about you guys. And when you first, when the microphones were first coming up, when Chris was first lighting up the sound, and you guys were singing together, it was really obvious that you were in total control of something you were very familiar with. And it was an ease and comfort that I don't get a chance to see with players, even those that have long-term intimate experiences. And it reminds me as a kid of listening to Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, where they had this miraculous, crazy, almost accidental sound start to happen. And that was the first time I ever felt that way, and it's been very, very few times since. So thank
you. Well, that's awesome. I love how they had the fourth voice, you know, in there before Neil. I mean,
right.
It was just three voices, but it sounded like, you know, this is like a fourth instrument, you know. And that's what I've always been a huge fan of Leuven Brothers, and first the Everly Brothers, but then the Leuven Brothers and Brother Duo sort of country stuff. I've always loved family harmony. And that's, you know, you're going, it's definitely something kind of magically you're going for, you know, going for that, in our case, the third voice.
We felt that.
We did.
Awesome.
Did you, on the tour that you're on now, are y'all playing as a duo or do you have the band with you?
We're playing as a duo.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Obviously you can pull it off and sustain it, you know, rather well. You guys are playing with Nick Lowe tonight.
That's right.
I told Gina, I said, you know, Nick Lowe better bring his F and A game because you guys were on, and he is truly amazing.
He always does. His A game is you know, beyond A plus. You know. So.
Yeah. Well, so is yours. And
speaking of tours, go ahead.
No, I'm sorry. I'm all up in it because I'm so excited to have these guys here. We were talking about John Bryan a little bit in the hallway, and your arrangements are lush without being extravagant.
Oh, well, thanks.
You know, very, very compact, as a matter of fact. And that's somewhat of a rarity. And John is good at making those kind of records. But I think that you guys have it distilled down to even a finer, you know, point. When you're songwriting together, how does that work? And, you know, who brings what to the table?
Well, yeah, you know, I guess we both, you know, bring tunes in and sort of look at them, you know, together. But, you know, I think over time, I mean, even with the first Autumn Defense record, which was all my tunes, I approached Pat as an arranger. So that's his strengths were there even then. And his songs came into the band by the second record. But he's been the arranging Svengali. Not that I'm without any ideas, but, you know, I definitely try to get things as close as I can. And I think I've improved over the years just watching him do it. But he's definitely been.
And our sensibilities are so, you know, have from the beginning been so much on the same page that, you know, we really sort of, you know, we didn't really have to discuss too much about what we wanted the records to sound like.
That's understood.
It's pretty understood, and it's so it's nice. It gives us a lot of freedom to you know, get a lot of the debate and discussion out of the way and just kind of realize it.
Well, I think that you guys left an incredible layer of love on Studio A.
I'm
sorry, I'm keep talking. Do you
I'm
have anything
still swooning.
You want to say?
No,
this is very sweet.
Besides, you know, hoping that Houston is your next favorite stop on tour, where do you love to be in the U.S. and abroad?
Well, we're going to Austin tomorrow, which is one of our favorites.
The other Houston.
Yeah, exactly.
Houston's little sister. Little musical sister.
Austin is awesome.
Well, yeah. Texas in general.
Yeah, there's Texas has got soul. I'm sorry. I mean, it's like just having, I had the honor to play with Doug Somm and meet him and know him a little bit. And you know, the San Antonio scene and just how much soul there is. I mean, we've been in it. So, like, I saw Alan Toussaint in New Orleans yesterday give a little performance. And I just feel like getting out of the north and coming down here and taking this drive, it's like, it's, you know, good for the soul. You know, and Houston is obviously a Towns Van Zandt, Live at the Old Quarter, one of my favorite records. I mean, there's just everywhere you go, it's just soul, you know, it's great.
We're good. We're glad you recognize it. It's a special thing for us, and a lot of times people miss Houston because of just where we are. Have to make that extra jog down from when you're leaving New Orleans. So we're super glad that you're here today.
Thank you
so much.
It's a beautiful place.
Really appreciate it. Thank you so
much. Episode 34.
Signing off. Can it get better?
No. The Autumn Defense, Laura Bricky with Vitamin Water, John, Pat, you know, and keep doing that cool little side project, Wilco. I mean, that's, you know, that may work out for you as well.